Good morning, grade 4. Today we are going to learn about a sentence. I know that we took this more than one time, but I need to make sure that we don't finish being in grade 4 without knowing what is a sentence and how to combine or to write a correct sentence. Today we are not going to write a sentence because of course you all know how, but we will know how to combine sentences together to make more than one sentence so we can form a paragraph and more paragraphs that talk about a specific topic. Now if you look at here, when I read it, there are 8 planets in the solar system. If we look at this, we can say that this is a sentence. Why? Because number one, it is grammatically correct. Number two, it has a meaning, so I understand it has a meaningful thought, so I understand what is the sentence talking about. And of course, if we go to the punctuation, everything is written correctly. There is a subject and there is a verb. But when I look here and hurt his knee, definitely this is not a sentence because I'm not talking who's the subject. I don't know who's the subject. I don't know about what you're talking exactly. There is no meaning. Okay, somebody came to me and he just said, and hurt his knee. So what does that mean? Who hurt his knee? And what was happening? So how did it happen? Give me the subject of the sentence. My sentence isn't complete, so it is not even a sentence. The horse galloped around the racetrack. Yes, this is a sentence. It has a meaning, it is meaningful, and it has a subject and a verb. So, it is a sentence. Ready for dinner. Who's ready for dinner? Who are you talking about? There is no subject in here, so this is not a sentence. So, simply, the sentence is meaningful thought. It should be understood easily. It should have minimum one subject and one verb. If my sentence has one subject and one verb, so it is simple. My sentence is simple. So Scott plays soccer in the morning. Scott is my subject. Plays is the action verb. And my sentence is meaningful. It has punctuation. Started with the capital letter. My sentence is simple. Birds wash themselves in our bird bath. Birds is my subject. Wash is the action verb. My sentence is meaningful with only one subject and one verb, so it is simple. Go and read chapter books. Tom is my subject. Can read is my verb. One subject, one verb, a meaningful sentence, so it is simple. But when I say compound sentence, it means that I have to add a conjunction because on the compound sentences, I don't have only one sentence. I have two or more sentences connected together with a conjunction. This kind of conjunction is called coordinating conjunction. We have two types of conjunctions, one used with the compound sentences and conjunctions used with the complex sentences. Today we are talking only about the compound sentences and the coordinating conjunctions. So when we say compound sentences, it means more than one sentence connected together or combined together with a conjunction. These kinds of conjunctions that we are going to learn are coordinating conjunctions. You need to know this. Okay? So, my coordinating conjunctions are all found on the word fanboys. Just memorize the word fanboys and you can know what are the coordinating conjunctions. The coordinating conjunctions in the word fanboys are F for for, A for and, N for nor, B for but, O for or, and Y for yet. So, for, and, nor, but, or, yet, fanboys. These are my coordinating conjunctions. I use the coordinating conjunctions to connect more than two sentences or two sentences together. So I just need to know how to use the coordinating conjunctions. If I want to use them correctly in my sentence, I have to know when do I use each one of them. So when I say Jake drove the car and Mary read the map, I am talking about compound sentences because I have one sentence and another sentence connected with the coordinating conjunction and. Jane is coming over. This is a sentence. So we can go for a swim. This is another sentence. Two sentences are connected by a coordinating conjunction, which is so. I'd like to go to the football game, but I don't have a ticket. Two sentences as compound are connected with a coordinating conjunction, which is but. So, simply as it is, when I say a coordinating conjunction, I am talking about the fanboys. Fanboys. So, of course, you need to know when do I use each one of the coordinating conjunctions. So let's start with for. For is used to show a reason. It is the same as the word because. I use it to show a reason of my sentence. Fans love to watch Aang, for he dances beautifully. Fans, the fans, love to watch Aang. Aang is a dancer. Why they love to watch him? For he dances beautifully. For as a conjunction took the place of because. So for, it has the same meaning of because. It comes in the sentences to join them together to show a reason. Fans love to watch Aang because he dances beautifully. Fans love to watch Aang for he dances beautifully. For gives a reason. And is the same as addition. I add. She appears on stage with a beautiful dress. And she was very happy. And gives the same meaning as also. It is a glue word that connects two sentences as if you are saying the word also. She appears on stage with a beautiful dress. And she was very happy. But is for the contrast. It shows positive and negative. Something happened positively and the other thing negatively. I would really like to go outside, which is something good for me. But we have to stay home to be safe. It is unexpectedly. It is the opposite. I give two situations. These two situations are opposite of each other. I would really like to go outside. So the simple situation that you go outside. But there is another thing that happened which is unexpectedly. So it didn't allow me to go outside. But we had to stay home to be safe. Or used for option. So, I have more than one option. I have more than one choice. I need to choose. She can choose to meet her friend or to go with her mom shopping. She can choose to meet her friend or to go with her mom shopping. I have two options connected with or because I need to choose only one. So is used as cause and effect. It shows the result. Okay, let me show it to you. So it shows me the result. It doesn't give me the reason. It shows me the result. What happened at the end. Like cause and effect. He is imaginative and talented. Okay, good. We knew that he is imaginative and talented. So what? So he can join the talent activity club in his school. It is a result of something. Okay? It shows me the result as cause and effect. It was raining heavily outside, so I had to take my umbrella. What is the result of raining that I had to take my umbrella? What is the result of becoming imaginative and talented? He can join the activity club or the talent activity club in his school as a result. Okay. Nor. Nor is used when you have both sentences that are not. I mean, both sentences, the first and the second part, are always not as negative. How? He doesn't eat cake, nor does he eat biscuits. This sentence means he doesn't eat cake and he doesn't eat biscuits. Here, he didn't do the thing, so it is not. And here, he didn't do the thing, so it is not. So the first part is not. The second part is not. I didn't wake up early, nor I didn't take my classes. So I didn't wake up early, which is not. And also, I didn't take my classes, which is also not. So with the word nor, or the conjunction nor, the part of the two sentences should be with not. I mean, I didn't do the thing. It is not approved. It is unapproved. Okay? Yet has the same meaning as still, or when we say but still. For example, he's overweight and feels terrible. Okay, now when I read the first part, he's overweight and feels terrible, so I expect that they will say that he will go on a diet program, right? But look at the rest of the sentence. He's overweight and feels terrible, yet he continues to eat lots of cakes and biscuits. As if I'm saying he's overweight and feels terrible, but still, he continues to eat lots of cake and biscuits. So it is the same meaning of still. I am still doing the thing. I didn't stop it. I might or I had to stop it, but I didn't stop it, although it is wrong or unacceptable. He's overweight, so he has to be on the diet program. But still, he's continuing to eat more food. Okay, so yet gives the same meaning as still. We listened eagerly. Why did we listen eagerly? For he brought news of our families. So because he brought news of our families, we listened eagerly. We listened eagerly for he brought news of our families because. She didn't speak to anyone, and nobody spoke to her. They rushed to the hospital, but they were too late. I will go shopping or I will go camping. Two options. I was feeling hungry, so what is the result? So I made myself a sandwich. I go to the library for I love to read. Because I love to read. Anne likes to read and write. Addition. The virus cannot live in immunized individuals nor in nature. So the virus cannot, here I have not, cannot live in immunized individuals and also cannot live in nature. So both sentences have the not. Not and not. Not here and not here. She objected at first. It means she refused at first, which is something negative, but finally submitted. She refused at the beginning, but at the end she said okay. Negative, positive, but. You're going to have a little brother or sister. Choices. The weather was cold, yet bright and sunny. The weather was cold, but still bright and sunny. I know you must be tired, so I will let you rest. So, for, the same as because, and, addition, nor, both of the sentences are negative with not, but unexpected things or positive and negative things, or when I have options or choices, yet the same meaning as but still, so it gives me the result, like cause and effect.